So our teachers will say, you eat outside, don't eat in the school, in the class. Means that you are bad and that manner is not good. So negatively he wants to say that eat outside. Don't eat here means eat outside. Don't bring dirty feet here. It means that cleans it. Means clean and then come. So clean, make it clean is the implication. Or when you say, oh, or we have been taught poetry, Sanskrit poetry. Oh, that there is moon is coming up in the sky. In fact, there was no moon, but one very beautiful lady come just enter in the classroom. So this is what is called simile. Moon is coming up. So means she is as if the moon. So here we put the image of moon and superimpose on the mouth of that girl or the lady. So this is called upama. It is also measurement. Understand the word measurement. Ma means to measure. Primary measurement, if it is there, then it is direct ma, means measurement. If it is secondary, it is called anumana. Mana means measurement. Anu means you have something, unit, and then you follow that unit. 1 inch, 2 inch, 3 inch. First one unit is the mana, measurement. And second, third, fourth will be anu, following. So that is anumana. And upa means still secondary, not primary. Upa. Therefore, so moon, face is like moon, but not moon. So this is simile, or we call it some kind of parallelism. This is parallel to that. So this is upama. And then, so we have seen mana, that is pratyaksha, anumana, upamana. And sometimes you have all this put together is called yukti. Sometimes you get some direct perception, some indications, some references, some implications, some simile, and so. So all this put together, then it becomes yukti. Yukti means yojana, means what we call coordination. Coordination in terms of Descartes' geometry. Coordinate, ordinate is coordinate. What does this do? One can give an example. That patient has come. Doctors take some medicine from this box, some medicine from this box, from something else, put into the and mix it and give it him. So this is all this put together, integration is yukti. And yukti requires experience plus knowledge and plus what you call it, pragmatism. It is called knowledge, experience and plus dhi, dhruti and smriti, we call it. So these three put together. You must have experience, you must have knowledge, and you must have also what is called deciding capacity, buddhi. So these three, this is called yukti. Yukti means all heterogeneous things put in proper and give one as a whole. All proper assembly of is called yukti. So as we say, there are so many parts put together. And then you put it and then you make it, that is yojana. Therefore, yojana means planning commission, as we say, yojana. So yukti. And so it requires intelligence, experience, and those faculties, higher faculties. And sometimes you do not get that also. Sometimes you have heard it somewhere else in the past. It is called iti, itihasa. But if this has some has taken place somewhere in the past, that also is regarded as a proof. It has only happens, it has happened only once. But that one historical event also can be used at a time endorsing this particular knowledge. It is called aitiya, itihas. And sometimes called sambhava, probability and possibility and probability. It is possible. Is it possible at least by idea? Yes. Then also it should be accepted. When others are not there, then these are used as a, what you call it, reserve thing. So probability. Sambhava. This is possible that I can create this machine. I have this idea, but are you sure? I am not totally sure, but probably I will be able to. This is probability. Probability is okay. But first it is uncertainty. I am not certain this will work, but most probably this will work. So certainty, there is no certainty, therefore it starts with uncertainty. Uncertainty, but not total uncertainty. So something, Kyle, what is probability? Not probability, but it is also possible. So probability, and again coming nearer is possibility. Yes, it is possible. So uncertainty, probability, possibility, and again there is something. But even if you are able to do that, but will you do better? Your father will say something, your mother will say something, your teacher will say something. Whether it is plausible, whether it is proper or not. Proper, improper means plausibility. There was some kind of competition. How many mangoes can you eat? So one has eaten 10, one has eaten 15, one has 25, one has 20, 50. Though it is plausible, but is it plausible? It is possible, probable. But is it plausible? Is it proper, improper? But after 50, he went on to the hospital. So plausible indicates what is called, what is wrong and right. What is wrong, what is right, what is good, what is bad, what is temporary, what is long time. So all this is called plausibility. And then actuality, then make it actual. So we started from uncertainty, second, probability, then possibility. It is probable, but who will do that? Who will do that? Possibility means, who will do that? So possibility means again assigning something to someone. Yes, it is possible for him to do that. Possible is directly again localizing it. And plausibility is pros and cons, good or bad. And then actuality, then actuality. These are the stages involved. And sometimes apta pramana or agama, you know, agama is the word in Jainas also. Agama, which comes from tradition. Some knowledge, some kind of knowledge which is historically, traditionally coming down, legacy. There is no proof. But it is established in the tradition, the society with that. And therefore establishment called agama jnana. I don't know, but my father's father was saying that. So that also is taken as a proof, to prove something. And not only agama, but also apta. Einstein said that this is possible. I don't believe in others. He said, therefore I will do it. Apta means one who has realized that knowledge, and if he gives some suggestion, that also is to be taken as the source for knowledge. So when he says that, he said that there is no other proof except that man. But apta means one who is knowledgeable, who is not bluffing, and who has already done that. We call it one who has shastra jnana, vyavara jnana, tantra jnana, and such a man is called apta, trustworthy. Apta means trustworthy. Apta. Apta. Apteshta. In Marathi, Sanskrit, we say. Those who are fully trustworthy. And if trustworthy man says, that also becomes a kind of proof. You know, the Chief Justice, even if he says, he just indicates, and that is taken as the order. Only by oral, that itself becomes oral. So President's oral instruction is also a valid knowledge. So it is called apta, agama. And then anupalabdhi, by in absentia you get some knowledge. Anupalabdhi, upalabdhi means directly seen, perceived. Somebody has seen, somewhere has seen. But anupalabdhi, negative way of knowledge. That is called knowledge in absentia or knowledge by exclusion. Just go give an example in ancient Indian context. In Indian tradition, when the couple gets married, when the boy and girl gets married, and the girl comes from maternal home to paternal homes, and a time comes when all her friends are there, and all his bridegroom's friends are there, then the newly married one, her friends tell us, who is your husband? She just keeps quiet. There are about 10 here and 10 those girls. She says, she doesn't speak, she just keep mum. Is he? She says, no. Is he? No. Is he? No. Is he? No. And when it directly comes to, she just keep quiet. Yes. Means, so this is by absentia or by exclusion or by some other means that you get that knowledge. So anupalabdhi, upalabdhi, so these are various means of knowledge. And India had tried all those things. And you will find throughout the world that somewhere other this is connected to some other kind of invention or what you call it, discoveries. So this paradigm which we have found it is the most ancient one, but it is so much ancient that it is eternal, therefore it is applicable in even in any coming modern situation. So it is what is called omniscient, omnipresent and omnipotent. Omniscience means total knowledge. Omnipotent, everywhere remaining there. And omnipresent, omnipotent and omniscience. So it is what we call space-time motion approach to this. And as I said, this is omniscient, omnipotent, omnipresent. It is called sarvajna, sarvatra and sarvakala. It is everywhere. Bhagwan ko sarvajna hai, sarvajna, sarvatra hai, sab taraf hai, aur sab samay ke liye hai. This is like your Java programming. Basically, Java programming was best to provide that it should be any platform, independent of the platform. Polymorph and multi-thread. And morph means external body, polymorph. At the time of fear, some kind of pseudo drama takes place. He changes his face every time. Polymorph, bahumukhi, like our Ravan had 10 dashanan. So polymorph means he can change. He can change his form. Morph. Morphology is the word for medicine and so on. Polymorph and multi-thread. Multi-thread means so many threads. This is what your grandmother does for her baby. 2 years baby, she prepares from threads, woolen threads, and she prepares ganji frock or sweater. So it is multi-thread, polymorph, and she prepares so many out of that small threads. She prepares cap, she prepares pajama, she prepares this and that, polymorph. So multi-thread, polymorph, and independent of the system. Therefore, Java became more. It is the same way. In Sanskrit, this is again found in the Rigveda. Indraha mayabhi pururupayate, Indra, illuminating God. Because of his maya inside, he has powers called maya. Pururup, he becomes multimorph, polymorph. Pururup, puru manji bahu. Morph means abhi ye banta hai, wo polymorph. This is the source of Java and source of computer science. Maya means powers inside. He has measuring, maya means measuring power. Measurement system. So by measuring system, he uses many measuring systems. And because of that powers inside, he can take any form anywhere in any way. Indra maya bhi pururupayate. He himself becomes many. What is called manifold in modern mathematics today. Manifold maithe na? Manifold is a big term in mathematics. Manifold. First it was Riemann geometry is based on manifold system, on which Einstein based his Riemann and Minkowski, on which Einstein based his theory of relativity. That which is called Riemann in sheet. It's nothing but polymorph. Bahurupa. Pururupa. So it is given in the Vedas. Indra mayavi pururupiyati. He himself becomes manifold. Many folds. And rupam rupam prati rupo bhava. Not only that, rupam rupam prati. With each form, he becomes one with everyone. So even with that form, he becomes that. With that form, he becomes that. So he is everywhere taking this, whatever appropriate form takes of it is his form. Rupam rupam pratirupa. He becomes counter form. Form counter form. Action counter action. This is in the Vedas, 5000 years back. Rupam rupam prati. So, he wants that, okay, he will get that.